Well, I think, Christopher, you asked if at any point I was concerned or frightened that I might not be able to take care of myself. And I said, no, I wasn't. But I do remember a funny story, because I was as frightened as anybody else up to a point. And that point ended in this funny story. I was sitting in the Army laundromat at Fort Dix, New Jersey, the day before we were being discharged from my first tour of duty, although I knew we would be in the reserve for 6 years and could technically, theoretically be called back. And I remember sitting in that laundromat and watching these 20 or 30 machines whirl around the clothing, whirling around, or because they had a door with glass in front. I think the washing machine has it even now, and you can. And I just saw this clothing whirling around, and I remember saying to myself, "What are you frightened of?" And I was frightened at that time, at 20 or 21 or 22. Or 23, whatever age I was. And I thought, I'm not frightened of anything except some terminal illness. In other words, I said to myself, what could happen to me that I could not recover from? And I couldn't think of one thing that I couldn't recover from except a terminal illness. So I said, if I got a job and I couldn't pay the rent, I could get some other job. I could move into the YMCA. I could become a dishwasher or a waiter or whatever it was. I could always support myself. And when I suddenly realized that there was nothing that I was frightened of, anything, I was liberated from the question you asked. And I've never been frightened since. And obviously I've saved some money after my penguin years and after, given my age and so on. And if I lost it all, it's not a great fortune, but if I had nothing, I wouldn't worry even today. I know that my brain is still good and I could be of some service somewhere and I could earn a living and live in a little room. I don't believe any of that will ever happen, but I could. It wouldn't be the end of me.